So just to kind of explain what's going on here, it was about 11:40 a.m. Officers were dispatched here to this funeral home. It's located at 11525 Blue Ridge Boulevard, dispatched on a shooting. When they arrived, they found three victims who had been shot. We had one adult female victim who was inside the funeral home, one adult male victim who was in the laundromat next door, and a third adult male victim who was outside of the funeral home. I'm sorry about that. Yep. All three had been shot. All three were transported by EMS to local hospitals. There was a fourth person, an adult male, who had a minor injury. We don't know if that was a graze wound or from a, you know, glass, or don't know what that is, but there was no treatment needed for that. Right now, the three victims at the hospital, two are in stable condition. One is in critical condition at this time. The preliminary information is that there was some type of a dispute that occurred here at the funeral home.
Inside the funeral home?
Inside, outside, I'm not sure specifically, but involving people who were basically already here is the information preliminary that we have.
Was there a funeral occurring?
Yes. So a funeral, from what I understand, had just ended. Some type of a dispute occurs, and a shooting then ensues.
Do we know what the dispute was about?
No, that'll be all part of the active investigation, working to determine, you know, what in fact led up to this, what the dispute was over. We don't have any suspects right now. We don't have anybody in custody. We're obviously daytime. There were people here. We have people who are talking with us. So we're trying to figure out, you know, who was involved, and again, what happened, what led up to all of this. So we would ask for the public's help, as always. If you have any information about what occurred, or if you saw something, you can also call TIPS hotline, of course, if you want to remain anonymous. But that is really all the information we have right now. Again, the most recent update, you know, two stable and one critical. So hopefully that, you know, that remains the case, and then they can continue to do their work at the hospital, do all their magic and help them pull through.
Is this a location police are often called to?
You know, I don't really know as far as this actual funeral home. I mean, unfortunately, as you guys are aware, we do get dispatched to shootings and funeral homes. I don't know if this is one that we've come to prior. I have not been out here, but that I don't know. I would say, though, in general, and this is kind of a business district, you know, to some degree, I don't believe it would be, you know, a common occurrence.
Okay. Is it threat to the public over?
Well, yeah, what I will say is this scene is confined, obviously. We don't have suspects, so we are looking for who may have been involved. I don't know if that's one person who shot. I don't know if it's more than that. They'll be working to establish that. I will say, you know, we, of course, as we always do, get right on top of trying to determine who that is and begin the process of finding any persons involved. So suspects at this time are at large. We do not have them in custody. Any information, please call.
Whose funeral was going on?
I don't have that information. I don't know what, I don't know.
Was it anybody significant? Somebody known to police?
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay.
I don't believe this is anything, you know, preliminarily again, that was on our radar for any reason.
So the man who was in the laundromat, innocent, essentially?
It sounds like the person in the laundromat, not in attendance at the funeral, was in the laundromat doing laundry, I can only assume.
How many shots do you think, do we have any idea of how many shots were fired?
I don't know yet. Yeah, that'll all be part of the ongoing investigation as you know, as they're collecting evidence and looking for shell casings.
I was just going to ask, do you know what order the victims were shot in? Was the person inside the home shot first?
So, nope, I don't know any of that. Where I described where they were is where they were when police arrived. So I don't know, other than I know one was, you know, in the laundromat. I don't know where the other two were. I don't know who, I don't know any of that. They'll be working to determine that, you know, did it start in the funeral home? Did it start out front in the parking lot? We don't know any of that yet.
Was the fourth person with minor injuries transported to the hospital?
No, no, that's yep, minor injuries that didn't require any, you know, need to transport.
Yes. I had a question.
Oh,
so I apologize.
No, take your time.
Were any of the victims with the business, or were they all part of the funeral party that was there for that specific funeral?
You know, let me say that preliminarily, I don't believe any were like employees, if that's what you were talking about. No, I don't believe any were employees. From what I understand, they were all, you know, associated with the funeral. So, and that obviously, you know, could change. That's all based on, you know, the information we have right now. And as we interview people and look at evidence and collect more information, that something could change.
Any word on if the people in the funeral were the shooters? I guess the question is, how many people were at the funeral? Do we know that?
Don't know that.
Okay, so we don't know if it was big, we don't know if it was small, we don't know if the shooters were in the funeral or...
Yeah, don't know any of that. So they'll be working to determine, you know, did people know each other? Was, you know, what was this dispute over that led to this? We just don't know any of that yet.
But the public's help could help.
100%. Yep, always. You know, because you know, we will talk to as many people as we can here. We'll collect the evidence, but, you know, someone could have been driving by and seen something. It doesn't have to be that you were inside this funeral home when this occurred. You know, could have been driving by, could have seen something, could have heard something. Any of that information helps us, and the quicker the better, you know, so we can start to get on those tips and that information.
One more, not sure if you were able to talk to the owner of the funeral home, but did they have any regulations against having guns in their business or anything like that? Were they not allowed or anything like that?
You know, I don't know that. I don't know what this their particular take is on that. And again, I couldn't say either way if a gun was in there or if this was, you know, outside. So I don't know. I know each, you know, business owner obviously can make those decisions. And I would assume for the most part that, you know, people don't want there to be problems, and weapons can sometimes when people come in.
Maybe how many gunshots were fired?
I don't know how many gunshots were fired. They'll be looking at, you know, all of the evidence at the scene to determine that. I mean, I could say multiple, but yeah, don't know how many.
The two businesses on the very end.
Mm-hmm. Not that I'm aware of, and I apologize, I don't really know what the setup is here. I guess the laundromat's right next door, so I don't have any information right now that anything else, any other businesses were struck or people. Again, you know, as they take a look at that, there's always the chance that there could, you know, we find a bullet hole where that went into another building or something. But right now, I think it's just those two.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. Yeah. Always, you know, they'll be immediately looking at all that, any cameras in the immediate area, or and I don't know if there are or not yet, but we'll certainly be looking to see, you know, are there working cameras, or again, if there's individuals who had cameras. People tend to, you know, catch things on their phone pretty quickly. Yep, that's one of the first things we'll be doing, and looking for all that.
How many people have come forward as witnesses so far? Any idea?
Nope, I don't know how many witnesses they have. Again, you know, a unique situation as far as, you know, when you do have a crowd of people, middle of the day, I mean, a busy area. So we're hopeful that there's multiple people who will be able to share some information with us. But, yeah, I don't know how many.